Hey YouTube, Jim here. Welcome to Top 10 Archive. Even though PETA has earned the reputation for being overly aggressive toward those who violate animal rights, we often forget just how rampant and cruel animal testing was in the past. Today we're keeping those animals' memories alive with this Top 10 list of the most creepy science experiments done on animals.
Here, kitty, 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 kitty.
Number 10, Twoheaded Dogs. Starting our list out strong, number 10 are Twoheaded Dogs. No, it's not from a TV show. It's from the 1900s documentation of a Charles Guthrie experiment in which he grafted a dog's head onto another dog for 26 minutes. The latter part of the experiment was replicated, who knows why, by A.G. Konofsky and Vladimir Demikov. It's even said that Konofsky's Frankenstein-like surgery was accidental, wanting only to transplant a heart. In the end, Demikov got most of the fame for achieving the two-headed dog. In fact, he carried out the procedure more than 20 times in an attempt to perfect it. Of the 20, only one survived for about a month. Number 9. Blood of young mice rejuvenates old mice. The concept of a younger being's heart rejuvenating a much older one is ancient. Look at any fairy tale, or the case of Elizabeth Bathory. Well, scientists realized those stories might not be too far off, but still, don't try this at home. The researchers joined two mice together, one young and one old, to see the effects the blood of one would have on the other. What happened next is shocking. The older mouse started to see reverse aging in the brain and muscle tissues. We're not sure whether that's going to be tried on humans anytime soon, but it's a bit creepy to think about. Number 8, insects in the body. With this one, I'm not sure who it's worse for, the human or the animals. A researcher in Madagascar became very interested in the sand flea's sexual behavior. So far, a normal science thesis. Until you realize that there's a reason that their sexual habits are so mysterious. The sand flea, or chigger flea, burrows into the skin of warm-blooded hosts, swells, poops, reproduces, and then dies 47 weeks later, right there in the skin. If you're already feeling your hands sweat, just wait. The researcher let a chigger flea live in her foot for 2 months. Her results? Groundbreaking, actually. She found out that the fleas have sex when the females have already burrowed into their hosts. Disgusting, but fascinating, I suppose. Number 7. Turkeys aroused by severed heads? Ah, the 1960s. A different time, truly. Though many compare the 1960s to our current era, I'm quite sure there are almost no researchers attempting to make turkeys necrophiliacs. But hey, I'm just a guy on YouTube. Researchers in Pennsylvania noted that male turkeys would mate with fake female turkeys just as eagerly as with real ones. To see how far these male turkeys would go in their intent to pass on their genes, they experimented. First, the theory. They thought that if the female turkey's head matched their expectations, little else mattered. They started removing different parts of the model turkey to see how far the turkeys would go until they were no longer aroused. Even if there was only a head on a stick, they'd find it to be super hot. Body and no head? Eh, not so much. So what did they do next? They crossed that line we talked about. They took a severed head of a female turkey and put it on a stick. They did the same with a dried head of a male turkey, a 2-year-old female head, and a head made of wood. What did the turkeys do? Tried to mate with all of them. Number 6. Human brain, mouse head. Researchers at the Salk Institute started growing human brain cells by injecting fetal mice with embryonic stem cells. What does this do? It gives you the thrill of stem cell research and the horror of transgenic research and results in a very intelligent, squirmy mouse baby. Or perhaps a human conscience with a mouse body. We'll never know, and it might be better that way. Number 5. Dolphin gets intimate with a human. You heard that right. In 1967, the lines got real blurry between a dolphin and his speech trainer. Researcher John Lilly published a book where he talked about his assistant's relationship with a dolphin named Peter. Her duties were to teach him to speak, and they lived together in a flooded house for 6 months. They played, and she taught him a few basic English words. It wasn't long before Peter got affectionate and even attempted to mate with Margaret. Not to lead Peter on, she, well, helped the dolphin with her hands. As if that wasn't enough to get the project defunded, they also gave dolphins LSD in an attempt to make them talk. Someone should have told them if they wanted to talk to dolphins, they should have just taken the drugs themselves. Number 4, Vicanti Mouse. This mouse is pretty famous, but there's a chance you've never seen it before. The Vicanti mouse, otherwise known as ear mouse or Franken mouse, used to be the face of science going too far. To be precise, there was no ear grown on the mouse, so it wasn't engineered, but rather it was just stitched onto him. The ear is molded biodegradable mesh in the shape of an ear and was seeded with cow cartilage. The mouse was the power source to grow the ear, and it was done carefully since the mouse had to have no immune system to reject the ear. Soon the mouse's blood vessels infiltrated the scaffold and literally grew the ear. Number 3, the Lazarus Project. Ah, Lazarus. If you're familiar with the Bible, you'll know him as the man that Jesus resurrected 4 days after his death. In the 1930s, University of California researcher Robert Cornish put a theory to the test that he could revive dead things if their organs hadn't been severely damaged. To achieve this, he first killed the animals. To start, 4 fox terriers, all named Lazarus. Then he put them in a seesaw type of machine, which would circulate the blood by moving up and down while Cornish injected adrenaline and anticoagulants into their bloodstreams. The first 2 pups never came back to life. The second 2, however, did. They were both blind and severe brain damaged, but both dogs lived for months afterward at his home. Of course, what he had done was so horrible that the university kicked him out and he had to resort to other things. His next attempt? A death row prisoner who volunteered. The prison, with fear that he'd be free afterward, denied the experiment and the researcher's dreams collapsed as he lived the rest of his life as a toothpaste salesman. Number 2, Spider Goat. Apparently, silk spiders make silk harvesting quite a task. They're small, they're slow, and lab technicians milk thousands just for a single test tube. This sounds expensive already, I'm guessing. So what was their solution? Well, I think you already know. They took the gene that creates silk and put it into the genome of a goat. This was at the University of Wyoming in 2010, and to put it simply, it resulted in strands of silk in female goat's milk. The goats are supposed to be otherwise normal, but let's just hope they don't evolve into actual spider goats. Spider goat, does whatever a spider goat would. Okay. Number 1, to eat a shrew. In 1994, 2 scientists apparently got bored and decided to swallow, digest, and excrete a northern short-tailed shrew. Why a shrew? Why this experiment? So many questions. The New York anthropologists skinned and disemboweled the shrew, after which they lightly boiled it. Then one of them swallowed it without chewing. After it was excreted, they continued to study it to find out how it had ended up. Most bones made it out, except a jawbone, 4 molar teeth, most of a leg and foot, all but 1 of the vertebrae, and most of the skull. This means that all damage was done in the researcher's body since he hadn't chewed it. Essentially, they found out just how hostile the environment is in your stomach and intestines. Study inconclusive. Maybe try a hamster this time. Thanks for watching. I know these experiments were all a bit bizarre, but what do you think about the use of animals in scientific experimentation? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Don't be a two-headed, indecisive YouTuber. Become an archivist right now by subscribing, clicking the notifications bell, and giving this video a like.